Today we are going to learn to excavate terrain in the 2024 Revit. This procedure is actually specific only to 2024 versions because before 24 we had the building pad tools, and in the 25 and later the excavate terrain option is introduced, so we do not need this kind of cutting of terrain. But 24 was kind of left without the actual excavation tool, therefore we had to cut the terrain in the way we would cut other elements. We will use this component model in place tool, and this is the tool that is used to create the families that are in place, that are in the model. They are not the external files, but they are parts of the model. But before I start anything, I'm just going to create one section that goes right through my terrain. And also the building, so I can, once I create the void, just set it up in the section. So I go to architecture, I go to component, and I go to model in place. I'm going to assign it the topo solid category and I click OK. I now have to name it, and I can name it maybe topo solid void, for example, and click OK. Now what I do is I go to void forms and I go to void extrusion. I will just create the rectangle that goes around this building. Now you can set up the heights of this rectangle here, but I'm going to go to section and set it up there. That's why I created this section too, just so I can set up the heights of this extrusion. So now that I am done with the rectangle drawing, I just click finish. And now I go to section and I see how this rectangle I created looks like. I just pull it up to the part where I want to cut my terrain. That is this part of the building. It looks like this, and this is the area I want to cut. So I go to the cut geometry tool, and first I click on my void and then I click on the terrain. And as we can see, the part of the terrain that was inside of this model in place is gone. Once I do that, all I do is click on finish. And this is what it looks like. I'm going to go to 3D and we see that we have the perfect cut of this building. We have no more terrain in this part of the project, and this is what this looks like. Of course, if you ever change your building, you will also have to change this terrain. And in order to do that, I go to section back again, and I can even do this from 3D and from plan as well, but I find it easiest from the section to do it. So I select everything that is in the area of my in-place model, and I go to filter. I click check none and I only select topo solid. I click OK, and of course I do want to remove my actual topo solid from selection, so I hold the shift key on my keyboard and I deselect the actual earth. Now only this in place topo solid is left, so I can go to edit in place. And now I can select my void, so any sort of adjustment I make in the project, this way I can just do it in the void as well, and I can just update this void however I update my building. And also, since not all the geometry is going to be simple, sometimes you are going to have to create several voids. Of course, you can create more voids in one in-place model, but you can also do it separately. There is no right way. Whatever works for you the best, that's going to be the best option.